not sure what you'll find at Bolton Greens, but I am sure that whatever happened to the Gourmands, it was as grisly and inhuman as they were. Good luck! You'll forgive me for not watching this time.
Edie and I have been feeling a little extra hungry of late, and the others are starting to ask questions. Morris, how can you be hungry when you're still so fat? You know what I say to that. I'm hungry because I'm the boss here. It takes a lot of effort to wrangle these useless idiots so we don't all starve, and that works up an appetite. Honestly, it's been several days since we've come across any more food. Usual unsuspecting travelers have been harder to come by. I can only assume the damn cutthroats have been scaring them all away, or not sharing their bounds with us. Well, the others won't like it, but we're gonna have to go to Plan B. Edie's on board with me. And I've been thinking about Gregory. He's got a lot of meat on him. And he's been rather useless lately. Yeah, no one will miss him. Maybe his wife. And his little girl, perhaps. But Vanessa will know what's good for her, and she's too much of a good fighter to eat just yet. And the kid, well, I'm not a monster. Besides, kids are too scrawny.
Thank you.
Unless I'm talking to a corpse. I assume the gourmands just ate each other to death. I'll never ask what actually happened, though. The thought of eating another human grosses me out. Ugh. Makes me glad robots were never on their menu.